For we trust in our God, and through his unfailing love, we will not be shaken. We will not be shaken. We will not be shaken. For we trust in our God, and through his unfailing love, we will not be shaken. We will not be shaken. We will not be shaken.
Jesus. Cross as you wait for the crown. treasure you found. As I come into your presence, past the gates of praise, into your sanctuary, till we're standing face to face, I look upon your countenance, I see the fullness of your grace. And I can only bow down and say,
you are awesome in this place, mighty God. You are awesome in this place, Abba Father.
Church, let's learn it from the beginning together.
And as I come to your presence, past the gates of praise, into your sanctuary, to where standing face to face, I look upon your countenance, I see the fullness of your.
Good morning. Glad to be in the Lord's presence this morning. I just want to start by reading a scripture. I just had the scripture in my heart today, and I want to read it as we get started. So just as kind of in an attitude of prayer, if you would stand up. I'm going to read this as a prayer for us this morning, and just make this the cry of your heart, too, as I read it. You can just echo the words in your own heart. It's from Psalm 63. O God, thou art my God. I will seek thee earnestly. My soul thirsts for thee, and my flesh yearns for thee, in a dry and weary land where there is no water. Thus I have beheld thee in the sanctuary to see thy power and thy glory, because thy loving kindness is better than life. My lips will praise thee. So I will bless thee as long as I live, and I will lift up my hands to thy name. My soul is satisfied as with marrow and fatness, and my mouth offers praises with joyful lips. When I remember thee on my bed, I meditate on thee in the night watches, for thou hast been my help, and in the shadow of your wings I sing for joy. My soul clings to thee, and thy right hand upholds me. And Lord, we do thirst for you this morning. We desire you this morning. God, we know that your loving kindness is better than anything in this life, than anything we have, than anything we want. Lord, you are so much better than any of that. And so, Lord, this morning we come to you with that perspective, with that heavenly perspective, that your kingdom is what we seek first before all other things. And so, Lord, we're seeking you this morning. Lord, would you come and meet us and fill us, Lord? Show us our thirst for you. Show us the places where we're thirsty, where we don't even know that we're thirsty, God. Reveal that to us this morning. Lord, stir up hunger for you as we worship. In Jesus' name, amen.
What's happening? Again.
That's what he's saying.
You think that's what he's saying?
I think it's what he was saying this morning already. We need to go unplugged.
Let me tell you a story real quick. Got here this morning, and the sound system was not working at all. And we didn't get it working until probably halfway through what we would normally have practice. But what was funny is that Jeff came in, and he was thinking, before he got here, he goes, you know, we need to have like an unplugged Sunday. Kelly gets here and goes, I think we're supposed to have an unplugged Sunday. So, but we, you know, got the sound system working, and it worked all the way through practice, and then now it's not working real well. So guess what we're going to do? Let's follow, okay, but now wait a minute. This is, to do an unplugged Sunday is really different. Okay, which means you won't have these. We're going to come down there, and it's going to be just a stool, a guitar, and we're going to just see where it goes. You okay with that?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it.
You are. You are the one God. scales fell from Saul's eyes, and he could see again. He got up and was baptized, and after taking some food, he regained his strength.
this Holy Spirit who opens our spiritual eyes to understanding so that we see Jesus as much more than just a man. We see him as our Creator, the Jehovah, the Old Testament, the long-awaited Messiah, the only Son of God, the Redeemer of Israel, the Lamb of God, the Savior of the world, the Good Shepherd, the risen Lord, the Judge of the universe, the reigning and ruling King of Kings. Let me repeat for his glory. Jesus is our Creator. He is the Jehovah of the Old Testament. He is the long-awaited Messiah. He is the only Son of God. He is the Redeemer of Israel, the Lamb of God. He is the Savior of the world. He is the Good Shepherd. He is the risen Lord. He is the Judge of the universe. And he is the reigning and ruling King of Kings.
To you are. Sunday, everyone.
Welcome
to our living room. This is great. This carries a little bit. This was great. I loved it. Thank you for... if you're a newcomer today, you may have received a bulletin, a loop, when you walked in. If you didn't, we have plenty of those, so please take a moment to fill out the visitor section and place it in that clear glass box at the back of the sanctuary here. We'd love to get to know you a little bit better and find out who you are and tell you who we are. Dig deeper on Wednesday nights. We're going to be starting a new series this Wednesday night called Freedom in Christ. Freedom in Christ. It's a 14-week series, so please come. That's an awesome title. We're also going to be having a financial meeting on August 7th, and that's directly after the Sunday morning service. And all are welcome to attend to review the quarterly financials for the church. So please make a note of that on your calendar. At this time, Sally has an announcement about One Harvest Menu. So I'm putting you on the spot.
Reminder, new menus are now out. Please take one and post one at work or post one in your apartment complex. One Harvest, for you that don't know, is a food ministry program that helps provide food at a low cost. It is available to anyone. You do not have to provide proof of income. We are the only church in Georgia that accepts food stamps, so if you know somebody who needs help with their food and is on food stamps, have to get a hold of me, my husband, or the church, and we'll get with you and fill out the paperwork that needs to be done for that. We're doing really good in the pantry. We are still in need of cleaning supplies and toiletries, so if you get a chance to pick up some extra cleaning supplies or toiletries, we'll be grateful. But thank you for helping us with the pantry.
Jesus' name on their birthday, and we pray that many, many, many blessings will befall them. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Yay. We're seeing how it's working. Security team found a purse. If someone's missing your purse, they've got it out front. I just wanted to tell you that. And today we're going to give some testimonies from the youth group and from the On Purpose, the young adult group. And they're going to tell you about their mission trip. Sound good?
Yeah.
All right. So, yay. So, where's the youth? Who's first?
Morning, everybody. So I just wanted to, first off, before we actually get started with our slideshow and some of our testimonies, I want to say thank you to everyone who came to our car washes, to our fundraisers, to our events. You guys, everybody in here, were the reason we were able to do this trip. So first off, I want to say thank you to everyone. I also want to make a special thank you to the On Purpose Young Adults Group. When they were doing their fundraising for our trip to Washington, D.C., they felt that the Lord told them that they needed to tithe part of their fundraiser to our fundraiser. So I want to say a special thanks to all you guys. You know, thank you so much for what you guys did. It helped us secure what we needed for this trip. And I just want to say, you know, for me personally, this is my, you know, being the youth pastor, this is my first actual missions trip, taking the kids, kind of being the new youth pastor thing. And I'll say this was, not gonna lie, it was a little bit nerve-wracking for me, but, you know, that's putting it lightly. but I'll say it was a wonderful trip. God showed a lot. Did a lot of things in me personally, and I got to watch these kids blossom and do awesome things for the Lord this weekend. And so what I'd like to do first off is let's show our slideshow, and then we'll get into all the testimonies with the kids. So.
Lose my find.
So for those of you who are new here, just kind of a little bit of a backstory here. Me and Kelly have some dear friends up in New Bern, North Carolina, that they started a small little kind of house church kind of thing, if you want to call it that. And we felt that Lord had been kind of calling us to, you know, get in touch with them and see if there's anything that they needed help with at their, you know, their little church. And so we started praying. We got in touch with them, and they were like, absolutely, we need, you know, we have several service projects that we need to do up at our, because they meet at the YMCA in New Bern, North Carolina. And they said, you know, we've got a lot of service projects to do. And we'd love to have your group to come up. So, the week before, we went up on Wednesday, and Thursday and Friday, we did our service projects. We did, they had a bunch of tables that needed to be painted, some groundwork that needed to be done. They have a community garden that the YMCA has for a lot of immigrants from Germany and stuff like that have moved there. And they use the community gardens as a way to get those new people to come into the local community and get to know everybody. And so we had to redo all those boxes that you saw, clean them, weed eat them. And then Saturday, we kind of took a free day, and we went to the beach because, you know, we're right on the coast, and we had a fantastic time. And then that Sunday, we did a little bit of a worship for them, and we did a special skit for them. So that's just kind of a little bit of a background of what we did. And what I'm going to go ahead and do is pass it over to the kids, and they're going to talk about, you know, what was the most impactful thing on the trip. So.
Okay, so for me, the best part of the trip was actually at the end. On the way home, we were going to stop by Chipotle for dinner, but there wasn't a Chipotle on the way home. That was close by. So we had to make a different plan. We ended up going to a place called Fazoli's, and it sounded good, it was pretty close, and we were gonna just eat dinner there. So we got there, and we ordered, and we sat down, and our waiter came with our food, and he was really nice. His name was Krishan, and we decided that we should pray for him, but we hadn't decided when yet. So then we were praying over the food, and he came with another order. He was like, "Oh, did I interrupt you?" And we're like, "No." And then we asked him if we could pray for him, and we did. So we went about eating our meal, and he was really nice, and he kept just talking to us and just being really friendly. And then he asked us if we would sing a gospel song in the middle of the restaurant for him. And, you know, we did. We sang Good, Good Father to him, and it was just the most. I think he videoed it and put it on Snapchat, actually, because it was really good. See, I mean, like, but it was just such a God moment. Like, we sang, and like the restaurant was quiet. It was so, like, it was really, really special. So for me, that was the best part of the trip.
Forgive me, I lost some of my voice while singing. While we were on the trip, God kept giving me these dreams, and not knowing that those dreams are actually events that'll be happening, that will be happening on the trip. And last year, I actually got those dreams, and I didn't know what they were. I dreamt that we were driving, and then all of a sudden we landed in this like little area with the gardening, and as you saw in the video, the gardening boxes. And while on the trip, I kept having flashbacks to those dreams, and I'm like, oh, God gave me those dreams like, hey, this is what's going to happen in the future. I'm sending you here, not knowing that those dreams were actually the events that were happening. I dreamt of the flower gardening. I dreamt that we went to the beach, and I actually dreamt of meeting that guy Krishan at the Fazoli's. And I thank God that he gave me those dreams, because not knowing that those dreams came true, and we actually went up to the beach and to New Bern and everything, and that was the most impactful thing, because those dreams are actually God telling me, this is what I'm gonna send you to do. This is my mission for you guys to do, and that was the most impactful thing for me on this trip.
Hi, everybody. Okay, there we go. So New Bern was awesome. Everything was awesome. The ice cream in New Bern is amazing. But if I had to choose something, it would be that as we were coming out of the ice cream place, this girl stopped us. She was probably, 17? Yeah, about 17. And she said, hi, my name's Abby. Are you guys visiting? And we said, yeah. And she pointed out some places that we could go, and then she went on her way. The next day, we were at a park, and we were doing VBS for the kids. And she was there. She was at the park with some of her friends from her high school. And that was just awesome, because how is that a coincidence? That's God. So that was my favorite part.
I think my favorite part of the trip was the same as Lauren's, because we were just there and we were all having a great time. We had gotten out of the car and we went into the restaurant and we were all having a lot of fun just being together and just having fun in the car ride. And then we got in and then we ordered our food, and once we got our food, like Lauren said, we prayed over the food, and Chris John walks up and he's like, oh, I'm sorry, I did not mean to interrupt your prayer. And I think it was Miss Kelly, and she said, oh, no, you didn't interrupt our prayer. Would you mind if we prayed for you? And he's like, no, I don't mind at all. I'm a Christian. And so we got to pray for him, and it was really, really cool, because he was a waiter, and I thought that was just really cool, because he was serving us with a smile, and he was serving us with his whole heart, and he didn't even frown once. You could see it in his eyes that he just loved being there, and he loved serving us just like God loves to serve us. And that was just the best, because I could tell that he was a real person of God, because he just served just like God serves.
I think, like most of us, when we were at Frizzoli's, we were praying, and then Krishan walked up and he said, oh, I'm sorry, did I interrupt? We said no. Then he served our food. He's a really exciting guy. Then he came back and then said, can we pray for you? And then he's like, yeah, I love praying. Like, thank you guys. Then we prayed for him. Then a few moments later, he said, can you guys sing a song for us? And then we were like, yeah, sure. And then we sang Good Good Father for him, and he's just like, sing along. And he's filming it with his phone. Like they said, he probably put it on Snapchat. It was just a really awesome experience for all of us to see that that couldn't have happened without God. And it's just a really awesome experience.
My favorite part was VBS, because when we were at VBS, at first the kids weren't totally into it because they were a little uncomfortable around us because they didn't know us. But I could tell that once they started doing stuff, they were really excited, especially with the games. Even though a few kids didn't really want to participate, they still played. And they loved it.
One thing I want to do before I share my is I want to thank Annie. Annie came with us. She was she's not up here with us, but She was our mission trip nurse and mission trip mom. She and I were the moms of the trip, and so we were the ones that were like, are we sure we should be doing this? And, you know, make sure everything was safe and secure. And it was just such a joy to have her with us, and I was just so grateful how God used her on this trip. So that was just really, really awesome. For me, you know, this was, I guess, the third or fourth youth mission trip that I've been on at MVC, and it was such a different trip for me, because like this group of kids, I call them the homegrown group of kids, because they're homegrown. These kids have been in this church, most of them, their whole lives, you know, most of their lives, and so these kids are a product of our body, and that's just really special for me. I mean, it's just really, really special for me, because we've been with these kids in kids ministry from the time they were in pre-K, and just to watch the Lord grow them up in Him and to watch what He's doing in the lives of the families they represent and the parents, and then just to see all of that fruit, it's just such an amazing thing for me. And so to watch what God did on this trip through this group of kids, it was so encouraging. For me, you know, and Jessica will probably test this too, this trip was all about God showing Himself to be real to these kids. And what I mean by that, we'd had some campfire times where we talked about this, but I mean, all these kids, you know, they're your kids. Their parents have so many stories. You all have so many stories about what God's done in your life. And we talked about how, you know, our parents have these stories and they have these God moments and these divine appointments and these things God has done in their lives. But it was like, this trip was like, it's our turn. It's our turn for God to start writing our story. And it's time for us to have moments, right? For us to have God moments that are God appearing and making Himself real to us. And we went around one night and I asked the kids, what do you want God to do in your life? What do you want, God? What do you want from God? And most of them, the answer was the same. It was like, I want God to do something that I can't explain. I want God to do something that to where I know that He's real. I want Him to make Himself real to me. I want Him, you know, I want Him to help me pray better. I want Him to help me see Him. I mean, really, really awesome prayers. And He did those kind of things on this trip. I wanted to really quick, just what Dalen was talking about with this girl, Abigail. This is an example of that. We got together. There was a picture of us in an ice cream place. And yes, the ice cream was fantastic. And so we had this ice cream. We were all just enjoying our ice cream. And we got ready to go. We were going to walk around the town. And I said, hey, let's gather up and just ask God for divine appointments as we walk around town today and see what He does. So we all gathered. I don't even remember who prayed. Marissa, maybe. One of you guys. So, because we always had the kids pray. I mean, it was like, kids, you do it, you know. So they prayed and they just said, God, would you bring us divine appointments? Would you bring us people that need you today? Literally, we said amen, cleaned up our stuff. We walked out the door of the ice cream parlor and this girl, Abigail, was standing there and she said, hi, where are you guys from? And we're all just like, and that was our divine appointment because we prayed, Jesse prayed for her. And we encouraged her, we prayed for her, we walked away, and the very next day we're at the VBS setting up, and this bus pulls up on the side of the road, and it was an art camp, and all these kids get out, and then that same girl gets out with them at the park. And the kids were like, that's Abigail. How could that happen? Oh my, I mean, they were just, they were floored. So they all together took off running across the park, grabbed her, and they were like, hi, Abigail, you know, and did y'all pray for her again? They just talked to her, and it was like, how could this happen? Well, they were able to say, God, you know, there's just no way. It wasn't that small of a town. So God just did things to make Himself known. And so just as we transition over into On Purpose, I just feel like this morning I'm supposed to ask us together that saying, you know, what do you want God to do in your life? And really, He says, just ask. We just asked. We said, God, we want to see You. Like we were singing this morning, we want to see You. We want to see that You're real. We want to have our own stories. We don't want to just know because someone else has had a story and someone else has had an experience with You. We want to have an experience with You. And so that's my prayer for us this morning, that each of us, that we would have our own experiences with the Lord and we would have our own encounters with the Lord and we wouldn't be riding on someone else's encounters. And that's really what happened. There was a transition on this trip with all of these kids. It's their walk now. It's their walk. And so I'm just grateful for that.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and transition to the on purpose. So bring up Miss Denise, or Mom.
All right, Pastor Mom, Reverend Mother. Let me get the on purpose group up here. Did you like that? So let's get everybody that went on the trip up here. And while we do a little transition, I'm just going to let you guys in on something. We decided that because our trip was so long and there's so many stories, that basically the stories you're going to get today are going to be on the screen. Because if we told them to you, you'd be here all afternoon. That's how awesome this trip was. So where's my team at? I got one more coming. Yeah, Jeff. Where's Jessica? Oh, that's right. Okay. So we'll wait on Jesse there. And if you guys can turn the house lights down, that would be really awesome. Can you turn those down too there, buddy? All right, go ahead and get it started if you can't turn those down. Blah, 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 DC, blah, blah, blah.
Hi, I'm Larry, and I would say that one of the most amazing moments that I had was bumping into a young lady named Laura on the train to Arlington Cemetery. We were talking about the event.
And raise the volume up for me, Sarah. All right. You guys good? Good.
Hi, I'm Larry, and I would say that one of the most amazing moments that I had was bumping into a young lady named Laura on the train to Arlington Cemetery. We were talking about the event and how God's plans sometimes don't match ours and what our group was doing there. Then she realized that she was on the wrong train. She showed 20 seconds of courage, came back up to our group and asked if she could join us, and to which our group said, yes. She joined us for a few hours, but in doing so solidified in me the idea of going with God's flow over creating our own. She also said if we had another one to let her know, she would love to join us in the future. So Laura, you rock. And I like forward to the future events.
Hi, I'm Sarah, and we went on missions trip, right? So we were being on mission and on purpose about our prayer walk, which is amazing, powerful. People were staring at us. We literally felt like we were changing the atmosphere as we moved along, which was amazing. But the most surprising thing for me was the personal touch. I'm a descendant of John Adams and John Quincy Adams, and so I saw their hand signature on the Declaration and the Declaration of Independence and Constitution. And so that was a personal touch, saying that I got to pray for a nation that I was physically a part of. And so after walking 3 days, 37 miles, 90 degree weather, the best part is that I came home refreshed. And so I just want to say Jesus really does change everything.
Hey guys, my name is Yoav, and I had a wonderful time at our trip. And the thing that God touched my heart the most with was the fact that we were able to pray in Washington, D.C. in the locations that we prayed at. We were fighting in the spiritual realm because, you know, the Bible says that that's what we battle against. You know, the powers of the spiritual world that try to come against us and trying to make a stand for Christ. So what I took from that is that we were actually making a physical stand there for the Lord and just making a stand against anything that was trying to come against Jesus and our nation. And I just want to encourage you guys to pray for our country and to pray for the leader whomever God chooses in this next election. And it was just a wonderful time, and I just thank God that I was able to be a part of it.
Hey guys, sorry I can't be here Sunday morning. I'm actually doing this from just outside of Yellowstone, but I wanted to just give a recap for me on what the event happened, the mission trip to DC meant to me. I was so amazed at all the opportunities that God gave us, and I'm sure the rest of the group's gonna go into detail of being able to pray for individuals. We got to our first prayer, we got to pray for a security guy that was right in the rotunda. in the National Archives. And then from there, we got to pray for some Secret Service guys in the White House, and just other times, people were even coming up to us asking for prayer on the streets. And it was just an amazing time for me on a personal note. Even though the event got ended early and we didn't get to pray in the prayer tents, was able to get just about a few minutes, about 10 minutes or so of the event for the last worship song. And to me, it just showed me just that this next generation is hungry and thirsty for God.
Hello, my name is Jessica. I had the opportunity to go to Washington, D.C. with the On Purpose group. One thing that really stood out the most to me was doing the prayer walk, going to the different areas, checking out the scenes, but most of all, praying and taking communion with the group. It was very special. Not only that, but we prayed for a shaking to happen in all areas. And what happened was Saturday we were going to go swimming, and there was a crack in the swimming pool, and they have no idea what happened or where it came from. So to me, that was really precious to see that God is making things happen. He's shaking things up, and it's really cool to see what he's doing, and I'm excited to see what's going to happen next.
Hi, my name is Linda, and I went on the All-Purpose DC trip, and the main highlight for me was mainly going to the White House and just seeing how the White House is our history in America, where all our presidents have been there, and just how they've set up this country for us, and mainly praying inside of the White House. And I really enjoyed it because I prayed that our next president would be someone who is wise and that will run our nation in the right direction for us and Christianity and for all people who come to America.
Hi, my name is Jeff. And my favorite part about the event was actually missing the event. God really used that as an opportunity to humble me, to realize that it's not about going to a concert, it's not about going to an event. We don't need the event to be changed. The hashtag that they kept using was Jesus Changes Everything. And the name of the event was Reset 2016. And what God really taught me is that He changes things now, He changes things in the future, but the truth is that He already changed things. So if you're upset that you missed the event, you didn't miss the event. The event is right there in your heart, that if you've already accepted Jesus, He's already reset you. You just have to accept it and believe it. And that was my takeaway.
Hi, my name's Jesse. I went on the On Purpose missions trip to Washington, D.C., and I would say the biggest highlight for me was being able to pray for the different branches of our government. From the legislative, which is at the Capitol, the executive at the White House, and the judicial at the Supreme Court. It was really awesome to be able to go to each one of those locations and pray for every one of those branches, especially with everything that's going on right now in our country. I just felt that it was a really awesome moment, not only for myself and for our group and our church, but also for our nation.
Okay, we're here live at the Together 2016 Reset. If you can see right behind me, to my right over here, you see the Washington Monument. And if you look a little bit over to the left, you'll actually see the mall is filling up with all the Christians that are here today praying for our nation and for DC and our government. The stage is all the way down over there. So we had to quit our prayer walk yesterday because we were hitting the wall at the last minute, so we decided to start afresh this morning. So with that said, we're going to go ahead and jump right in on our prayer walk time, and we're going to go ahead and pray. Heavenly Father, I give thanks for our government. I pray for all men and women having authority over us in any way. Pour out your spirit upon them and make your word known to them. Cause them to be men and women of integrity, obedience concerning us, that we may lead a quiet and peaceable life in all godliness and honesty. Let wisdom enter their hearts and let knowledge be pleasant to them. Let discretion preserve them and understanding keep them, to deliver them from the way of evil and from evil men. Make their hearts and ears attentive to the godly counsel, doing what is right in your sight. Let the upright dwell in our government. Cause there to be shaking in all areas. Let those complete and blameless before you stay, and cut off the wicked. Let the unfaithful be rooted out. Bring to light what is hidden in darkness and expose the aims of our hearts. Let this nation remember from where they have fallen, repenting and returning to doing their first works, setting their hearts and their souls to seek the Lord, humbling themselves, praying, and turning from their wicked ways. Then hear them, O Lord, and forgive their sins and heal our land. Open their eyes and turn them from darkness to light. Soften the hearts that are hardened through the deceitfulness of sin. Deliver them from their destructions. Father, you have been long-suffering towards us and not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Raise up a standard in this nation and cause the rains of your Spirit to flood this land and revive your work in the midst of us. Raise up intercessors for this nation to pull down strongholds over this land and let the glory of the Lord be revealed. In Jesus' name, amen. So we're just going to take a minute to eat. So let's eat. And let's drink. In Jesus' name, amen.
Time for us to do something. Come set your rule and reign in our hearts again. Increase in us we pray. Unveil why we're made. Come set our hearts ablaze with hope like wildfire in our very souls. Holy Spirit, church, we need your power in us. We seek your kingdom first, we hunger and we thirst, refuse to waste our lives, for you're our joy and prize. To see the captive hearts released, the hurt, the sick, the poor.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. I know it's late. People are already leaving. Some have left. But I did want to bring up just a couple of short things really quick before we say our goodbye to all of you this morning. You know, each one of us has a responsibility to be salt of the earth. Jesus said, be salt. So if you're not salty, get salty. By the way, we sweat a lot on those 3 days, so we were pretty salty. One of the things I wanted to talk to you about quickly was that while we were there, when Jeff mentioned the event was canceled, the event was canceled at 4 o'clock in the afternoon. We were supposed to be at a prayer tent at 5:30. At 4 o'clock, we got a notification on our cell phones from the Together 2016 people stating that they were shutting down the event. Emergency Management Services from the federal, this was a federal thing. This was not just something that just happened. This was a federal thing. They actually canceled the event. So at 4 o'clock, everyone was leaving. They had so many people that they had to take to the hospital. All we heard all morning while we continued our prayer walk to eventually get to the tents by 5:30 in the afternoon, all we heard the whole time in D.C. were the sirens. And it was just woo, woo, everywhere. And we thought, you know, really? That? And what it ended up being was Emergency Management Services taking all the people who were falling out from the heat. There was so much heat in the D.C. Mall that day that it was unbelievable. When I tell you unbelievable, I mean, really, there's just no other words to describe it. So that was another thing I wanted to bring up about that. I think on a personal note, I do want to tell you that the other event for me that was the most amazing thing, I told the group before we left, I said, I'm really praying that God gives us a tangible event that we know that something happened in the spirit. Did I not? So when we got back, I said to Jesse, hey, y'all go find out if we can go swim at the pool. The pool's closed. They didn't tell us why at the time. I said, well, go find out why. Maybe they had to put some chemicals in it. Who knows, right? So I said, go back and let's see it again. Well, when they went back and asked again, they found out more from the concierge or the front desk, and they told them, and they came and told us that the pool had a huge crack in it, and they had no idea where it came from. Now, the tall building that you saw in there, that's where we were staying. That was the Grand Hyatt Hotel in downtown Washington, D.C. That said, there were so many Christians in that building with us. And I know it wasn't just us, but I know God did something in that building. When you talk about shaking, quaking, and a pool breaking open with a huge crack, they were all freaking out, calling engineers. They were having them all flown in from at that afternoon because they were freaking out because they thought they might literally have to evacuate the building. But they didn't say anything to any of us. We were like, okay, whatever. And we were good with it. But that to me was another one of those things that was a highlight. There were so many things, as you could see on there, from, you know, the trip, the prayer walk itself, all the way down to being inside of the White House. We all had assignments that we had put on a board, and we said, Lord, give us scripture that you want us to pray in the White House privately, quietly, because we knew we weren't going to be able to. But if you saw the two pictures of the guys that we were in with, one guy had a suit on and the other guy was actually wearing a uniform, we had an opportunity. Those were Secret Service guys. And I just upped and said, hey, can we take a picture with you? And they were like, because that's like a big no-no. And I was like, yeah, come on, get in here. And he took the picture with us. And the other guy was like, no, don't pray for me right now. And Troy walked over, and instead of praying for him, he just walked up to him and prayed it like a conversation right there in front of everybody, God and Jesus. It was awesome. And every one of us were praying our scripture passages throughout the White House. It was a powerful time when we were there in the White House. So, I think the last thing I want to tell you is this one thing. I know that it took a lot for all of us to get to this point, but I really believe that it was a turning point for our nation, for us as individuals, and for us as a church. And that meant more than I can ever tell you. And I just want to thank all of those that, you know, here at Marietta Vineyard, who participated with us during the event itself, those who went to the Marietta Vineyard Facebook page. It's still up on there, so if you got to, if you missed all our prayer points, all 14 of them that are on that prayer walk cross that you saw on the screen, if you want to go back and look, we will tell you where we're at, and you can see and follow us along in case you missed it, if you want to go back and do that again. And then I also want to take a few minutes to thank Troy Farron for all of his hard work in the background. He helped set up a bunch of stuff. One of them was to actually get us all our passes to get into the White House. So thank you, Troy. A shout out to you. And I also want to shout out to all our donors in the church, because I know some of you snuck it in anonymously. And for those of you that did, thank you so much. You really have no idea that saved us from one more car wash. Thank you. Oh, my gosh. And I want to thank Jesse for putting the slideshow together for us. That was awesome. But most of all, yeah, that's right. Go ahead. But most of all, I just want to thank all of you all, the Marietta Vineyard Church, all your support, all your prayers. Believe it or not, if we had 2 or 3 more hours to tell you how we got from February to when we went on the trip and told you our journeys individually, it would just take hours and hours. And then, let's see, one last thing here, because this thing keeps going on me. So at this time, I know it's late, it's 12:15, I don't want to keep you any longer, but we were going to go ahead and open up the altar for prayer, and we were going to go ahead and call up the youth group here with us. I know it's late, so if you feel like you need to go, you're free to go. We're going to go ahead and dismiss, but we're going to all stay up here with the youth. And if you all need any prayer for anything, as you could see on the screen, we touched a lot of lives because the Lord led us to them, and they were also drawn to us. You wouldn't believe what these t-shirts did in D.C. It was amazing, amazing, amazing. So if you need prayer for anything and you want to come up, we're just going to go ahead and open up the altar at this time. So youth, Youth, there you go. Mm-hmm. Come on up with us. Kind of spread out in this direction. And for those of you who need prayer, just come on up. And if not, we're just going to go ahead and dismiss in prayer. Father, I thank you that, God, that you said to go into the world and make disciples of all nations. And so, Father, I just pray right now in Jesus' name that this futile event that we did, that we were all a part of with our youth group and with our young adults group, that, Lord, that you would fire everyone up to understand that the mission is here right in front of us in Marietta. And Father God, I just ask in Jesus' name that whatever was on these DVDs, that, Lord, these videos, that you would impart it to those that go out into the street. Lord, give us continued divine appointments and let us not be afraid, but to have courage to speak your word in boldness in the name of Jesus. And Father, I thank you for this church, and I thank you for all the leadership in it. And Father, I thank you for the groups that went out. In Jesus' name, amen.